It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Strategist here at Payne Capital Management. Stocks once again hit new, fresh, all-time highs this week. And when my bride of 42 years, my Valentine, asked me why the market went up, I simply stated there were more buyers than sellers. Truth be told, the market is an auction, and there's a seller for every buyer. And when there are more buyers than sellers, well, the markets simply rise. Speaking of auctions, the U.S. Treasury held an auction for 30-year bonds and sold $19 billion in long-term bonds with a record low yield of 2.06%. The 10-year U.S. Treasury note that was not auctioned closed at a yield of only 1.6%. Now, with a current inflation rate of 2.5%, the real return on both bonds is negative. Nonetheless, the demand was amazing. There appears to be an insatiable appetite for U.S. Treasuries, but not surprising when you consider there's nearly $14 trillion of negative yielding debt in countries like France, Germany, and Japan that guarantees you a negative return on your money. Now, Jeremy Siegel, professor of finance at the Wharton School in Philadelphia and one of my mentors, appeared on CNBC this week and pointed to low yields as one of the reasons stocks are not overvalued, even at 20 times current earnings. Dividends on stocks are higher than bond yields, something that's rarely occurred over the last 50 years. And he expects this to continue and stated rates will stay lower for longer and stocks should average 7% for the foreseeable future with a 5% capital gain and a 2% dividend. Meanwhile, he thinks we should not only breach 30,000 on Dow very soon, but hit 60,000 in a little over 10 years with, of course, substantial year-to-year volatility. Hey, sounds great. But before you break out the champagne, keep in mind when Dr. Siegel was asked if 10 years ago he foresaw the current environment of low inflation and low interest rates, he replied, of course I didn't, and no one else did. There were new factors we didn't expect, demonstrating once again, if one of the greatest minds in finance can't predict the future of financial markets, what chance do we have? But here's the great news. He's supposed to be right. We, on the other hand, only have to be approximately correct in order to create generational wealth and achieve all of our financial goals with a well-diversified, low-cost portfolio. Process-driven portfolios will always trump event-driven strategies. And as for Dr. Siegel's return expectations of 7% total return this year, well, I'm happy to report that our large company growth portfolio is already up over 9%, and it's only mid-February, and we haven't even received a dividend yet. Hey, for some of us, it's been a great year already. Now, if you're sitting there wondering, do I have a portfolio that's appropriate to my goals, to my dreams, to my values? Why sit there and wonder when you could know? My son, Ryan, and I have over 70 years combined industry experience in helping families like yours to build low-cost, tax-efficient, performance-driven portfolios. Hey, why not give us a call or simply text 844-752-6692. That's 844-752-6692. Or you can simply call 844-PLAN-NYC. That's 844-PLAN-NYC. This is Bob Payne, and I'm the Chief Investment Strategist of Payne Capital Management.